Hey everyone, welcome to Q&A. So today, Mohib Quadri writes, how much time or experience is needed for an employee to increase their pay and position immensely? If it doesn't happen, then what does one need to do? Excellent question, Mohib. Thank you for that. This is basically, you know, how to get a promotion, how to get a raise, how do I get promoted at work type question. Excellent. This is not a one-size-fits-all answer to it, okay? The problem is that in different industries and different situations, people place value on different things, okay? So that's the problem we're up against. However, despite that, I'm going to make three recommendations that will increase your likelihood of being promoted or being given a raise or even a bonus immensely, like you said. Okay. Recommendation number one, add soft skills. Now you probably have technical skills. Most people have technical skills in how to do their job, okay? So they are an authority in how to do their job. If you want to be promoted, the best thing you can do is tack on soft skills. Now, what do I mean by this? Soft skills are communication skills, collaboration skills, interpersonal skills, presentation skills, public speaking skills, coaching skills, conversational skills, all that kind of stuff, okay? People often underestimate how incredibly important this stuff is across the board, no matter what job you have, no matter what level you're at, these are incredibly important, okay? Let me give you an example. Most of us know that it is not possible to agree with everybody all the time. Just not possible. And if you do, something bad's going on. It's also not possible to always be the bearer of good news. A lot of times we have to be the bearer of bad news. We have to report that there's a problem. Okay? Now, people with great communication skills, one of the things that they can do is they can disagree and they can report a problem in such a way that the person receiving this information doesn't get their backup, doesn't go away hating them, doesn't take offense, okay? Doesn't label you as, you know, someone who's got an attitude problem or is not a team player, okay? Instead, when they hear this information, they think, okay, that certainly makes sense and I understand and I actually look forward to working it out with this person, seeing if we can resolve it. That's the difference that great communication skills makes, okay? And this applies in pretty much every situation where you have people working together, okay, and communicating. So this hopefully illustrates the importance of this stuff. Now, how do you tack these on? How do you get these skills? Well, two things. Number one, practice makes perfect. The more you practice this, the better you get. But you don't need any formal qualifications here. If you're wondering how to do this, go get yourself a book on it and read it just casually in your spare time. I always recommend textbooks. I think that textbooks, generally speaking, have much better information than all the other types of books out there. There's a lot of amateurs writing books on things that they don't really know about, and this misinformation gets out there. So I think what I'll do is I will put a link in the description to one book, but there are many, many others. Go look online. And then read it casually and then practice it. Having the ambition to do this already elevates you above everybody else who doesn't. Okay. So that's all you have to do. Tack on some soft skills. Second recommendation I would have that will increase the likelihood of you being promoted or getting a raise is to tack on management skills. Okay. Specifically how to manage money, how to manage people, how to manage projects, okay? These are very real skills, especially if your ambition is to climb the organizational chart, okay? As we go higher on the organizational chart and get promoted and promoted and promoted, generally speaking, technical skills matter less and less, but management skills and soft skills matter more and more, okay? So if you have an ambition of being promoted, being a manager, being in charge of things, okay, and you know, obviously the compensation that comes with that, Okay, you are going to need to know this stuff. Management skills, okay? Now, how to get this stuff? Well, in this case, I would recommend that you get a formal qualification. And before you leave thinking that, oh, I'm not gonna go back and get a four-year degree, that's just not possible, that's not what I'm suggesting. Here and now in the world, there's a lot of options for getting a certificate in some of these areas that show you know the basics of accounting, you know the basics of managing people, you know the basics of managing projects, you know, managing budgets, managing timelines, staying on top of the details of every thread of every project all at the same time, right? You can get a certificate in a month, requires maybe part-time work, a few hours a week. And in a month, you got a certificate to show this. Now, what you do with the certificate, I would recommend you send this, email this, or just send it to your boss or any other appropriate people at your organization, maybe even other organizations too, and just say, hey, look what I got. I got this. If ever you're looking for someone to take on a project or work in this particular area, let me know because I'm interested. Okay, that's what you can do with the qualification. You have to show others that you have these skills. So that's where having a qualification from a third party comes in handy, okay? That's the second thing I'd recommend. Third thing I'd recommend, okay, if you want to increase the likelihood of you being promoted or given a raise or a bonus, is to go on LinkedIn, okay? Hopefully you have a LinkedIn profile, and go and look at the profiles of the people that are in the positions that you're interested in. Okay, if you're wondering, I want to be promoted into this role here, you know, look up the people in that role. Look up the people that are in that role at your organization and also in your industry in other organizations, okay? And see what they have. Okay, maybe they all have the same qualification, or maybe they all have 15 years experience in a certain role. Or maybe they all have a track record of success in a certain area, okay? Look for patterns. If there's one thing in common that all these people have in that position, then it's very likely that that's what you need to get if you want to be considered for being promoted into that role, okay? So that's kind of something that you can do that will tell you in your specific situation what you need to do. Okay, it's not a general answer, it's a specific answer that will tell you what you need to do in your specific situation. Okay? So hopefully that helps. These are three things that will increase the likelihood of you being promoted or given a raise or even given a bonus. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. And remember, no matter what's going on in the world right now, no matter what's going on in your life right now, you are awesome. Never forget that. Take care. I'll see you on the next one.